carried you. I think we should come by appointment between you and Mr. Shriya Saab, because sometimes you miss both of you together, and that's a very heavy day for the people.
So he has put Russian on me already. He has told me to ask two questions and leave room for me.
Has he already?
Yes.
But he doesn't know how many parts of your questions you have. Any questions, please? Other than the two, B2, yeah?
Yes.
So I would like to know, can you explain what is the significance of the number 7? You know, the Surah Fatiha is the 7 verses of Surah Fatiha. When you go for Hajj, Tawaf is you do 7 times Tawaf, and then Sa'i you also do 7 times. What is the significance of this number 7?
7 is used not only by Islam, but also previously by Bible, to indicate a complete circle when a creation is completed. And also there are 7 days to a week, which is also common between every people. So this is a very significant word to indicate completion of one circle. So this is in the Holy Quran, Surah Fatiha indicates the completion of the circle of spiritual creation. It began with Adam and it got culminated in Ahlul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It began in the first book of Revelation, whatever it was, and was culminated in the Holy Quran. So the 7 is a word of completion and a full circle. Please. I'm looking at you.
No, no. You want to ask us? I don't mind saying that. You want to ask us? So my question is starting from yesterday, sir. I was asking about the Quran from Khatameen. Could it be, sir, Nafsi Amara and Nafsi Mutmaina be translated as Quran from Khatameen? Because, as you said, there's no book and there are no angels.
No, I never said no angels. Don't get you to
me. Sorry, sorry.
I said there is no book like your notebook. But the system of recording, as has been explained in the Holy Quran, is a different system. The recording system
is not like our jotting notes on a notebook, but everything which is done here on earth leaves its mark behind, like fingerprints. So that is the recording system. But I told you that there is a system, for every system in nature, there is a corresponding creation of angels who look after these things and run it. Otherwise, if they do not control things, the nature will go topsy-turvy. It is not like a machine which is going of itself automatically. For every organization, there is an organizer. There has to be an organizer and one who maintains that organization. This is the lesson drawn from the nature itself. So how can you conceive such a vast machinery of nature going on automatically? There is no automation about it. Everything is run and everything is being governed and looked after by some spirits, which in Quranic terminology are called malaika, angels as you call them in English. So some angels are particularly responsible for maintaining the system of recording. And those angels which are relegated the task in detail, there may be some individual angels responsible for some individual recordings. We don't know how many, because the Holy Quran says that the Junudeo Rabbeka, that is all the creation of the Lord, is unlimited. You can't count them. So they are responsible, and among those Junud are included the Malaika. So they are responsible, and maybe there are two particular ones for you. We don't know. For everyone, there is an internal system of recording. And that system is so vast and so detailed that hundreds of thousands of calculations, or even more, millions perhaps, or even more, because once one thinks of things going on within one's brain, at each site, millions of calculations are made by the internal computer of the brain. And co-relationship is recorded, the past reactions, similarities. So in a split second, this goes on. So that means if there are two angels responsible for one individual, they would be very heavily engaged, of course, because the things of recording going on within every individual are countless, absolutely fantastic how they swell when you come to think of them. That was your first question or the preliminary?
Preliminary.
Yes, all right, start.
This may be hypothetical question, but I was wondering if people kindly answer that. I wonder what would have been the
hypothetical
question. Yeah. I wonder what would have been the reaction of Sahaba Kram when Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam named 10 Sahaba as Jannati. They were foretold about it, and the got list of their names are.
You wonder?
Yeah, I'm sure they are all jealous in the way I think.
You wonder about it?
Well, sir, 10 of them were told, and the rest.
So the rest of the Sahaba must be yet wondering. Go back and give them there. All right, your next question.
This is that I was reading from the Marfuza, as a Muslim on the last of Islam, I said, Jisne meri takzeeb ki, usne Rasulullah ki takzeeb ki. Jisne Rasulullah ki takzeeb ki, usne Quran Majeed ki takzeeb ki. And then there are similar verses in the Holy Quran. Wa is qala Isa ibn Maryam,
ya Isa ibn Maryam.
In this one, sir, I want to know this Ismu Muhammad. Is it Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa or Hazrat Brahma Messiah?
What relation does it have?
Well, this is linked with this. I have three, four parts of the question.
I've explained it many times before that initially it is Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam who is mentioned as Ahmad, because he has two main attributes. One Muhammad and the other Ahmad. They are attributive names. Names carrying attributions and descriptions of his character. So when he was to come again, as in the very next surah, Surah Jummah, it is depicted. You know, this is the beautiful arrangement of the Holy Quran. In Surah As-Saff, Ahmad is mentioned. And